Students, children, today your science teacher Nisha ma'am is going to teach you chemical properties of metals and non-metals. So let us start with metals. First is reaction with oxygen. When metals react with oxygen, metallic oxides are formed. If we have some of the metallic samples like sodium, potassium, aluminium, magnesium, zinc and copper. When these metals are allowed to burn in the presence of air, metallic oxides means their respective oxides are formed. But children, do all metals react in the same manner? No. Some of the metals like sodium and potassium, they react very vigorously and the reaction is highly exothermic. But in case of aluminium, magnesium, zinc, it requires a comparatively high temperature. And copper, it does not burn, and at high temperature means when at hot, very hot copper piece, oxygen is passes through it, then it reacts with oxygen and forms a black layer of copper oxide. So children, in all these metals, they do not react with oxygen in the same manner. Some of the metals are highly reactive and some of the metals show very less reactivity. So, on the basis of reactivity of metals, we arrange all metals in decreasing order of their reactivity, and this is called as reactivity series. So, first let us write reactivity series of metals. First is potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, lead, hydrogen, copper, mercury, silver, gold and platinum. This is called as a reactivity series, and when we go down from top to bottom, reactivity of metals decreases. Now children, hydrogen is taken as a parameter. It is not a metal, neither non-metal, but it includes in this reactivity series to just check the reactivity of metals. Okay. As you can see that potassium is highly reactive and platinum is least reactive in this reactivity series. So when sodium and potassium, they react with oxygen, the reaction is highly exothermic, or even when we keep these two metals in open, they catches fire. Okay, so let us write the reaction of sodium plus oxygen. It gives sodium oxide Na2O. In the same way, when potassium reacts with oxygen, it forms potassium oxide. The formula of potassium oxide is K2O. Now let us balance the reaction. 4K plus O2 is equal to 2K2O. Similarly, in the same way, aluminium, magnesium and zinc, they require comparatively high temperature, but when they react with oxygen, the concerning aluminium oxide is formed Al2O3. In the same way, magnesium plus oxygen, that is magnesium oxide, is formed 2MgO. Now let us balance the reaction, and as in the same manner, when zinc reacts with oxygen, zinc oxide is formed. Copper does not burn, as we know, because it comes in the last in reactivity series. But when oxygen is passed over hot copper, then it reacts with oxygen and there is a formation of copper oxide, which is black in color. Now balance this reaction also. 3 here, okay, 3 2s are 6, and 2 Al2 as well as 4 Al plus 3 O2 aluminium oxide is formed. What is the color of copper oxide? The color of copper oxide is black color there. Okay. These metallic oxide, they are basic in nature. All metallic oxides are basic in nature. It means when we dissolve these metallic oxides in water, we get an aqueous solution. Okay, and when red litmus paper is dipped in aqueous solution of metallic oxides, they turn into blue color means rare litmus paper converts into blue color. So it shows that metallic oxides are basic in nature. But children, all metallic oxides are not soluble in water. Only alkali metal oxides are soluble in water. For example, sodium and potassium oxide, these two are soluble in water. Whereas magnesium oxide, it is strongly soluble in water, and these one, aluminium oxide, zinc oxide, these are insoluble in water. Insoluble in water. Now, when we react matter with oxygen, it means we are burning the matter in the presence of air. That is an example of combustion reaction. When all these matters burn in air, they burn with a particular flame. For example, the color flame of sodium is yellowish, yellow color flame. I am writing here the flame color of sodium. Potassium burns with lilac color, it means that is pale violet color. Okay. Aluminium oxide means when aluminium reacts with oxygen, the color of the flame is white grayish color. White grayish color. Okay. Magnesium burns in the presence of air with dazzling white flame, dazzling white colored flame. Zinc, it burns with, initially it burns with colorless flame and then it gives greenish blue color, greenish blue flame. Whereas copper oxide, again blue green color flame. Sodium burns with yellow flame, potassium burns with lilac color means pale violet color flame, aluminium burns with white grayish color flame, magnesium burns with dazzling white color flame, zinc and copper almost bluish green color flame. Okay. Sodium potassium oxides, these are soluble in water, whereas rest of the metallic oxides are insoluble in water. So if we talk about the reactivity series, highly reactive metals means potassium, sodium and calcium, they react with oxygen with a vigorous reaction and highly exothermic reaction. This is the reason that these metals are kept in kerosene oil, because these metals are, means potassium and sodium, these are highly reactive metals and they catches fire when we keep in open air, as well as if we store these metals in water, even they react with the oxygen that is soluble in water. So these two metals, potassium and sodium, these two metals are always stored under kerosene oil. Okay. Magnesium forms insoluble magnesium oxide, but all these metallic oxides are basic in nature, red, which turns red litmus paper to blue. Here children, we have one exception also. That exception is, I am writing exception with red color pen, aluminium oxide Al2O3 and zinc oxide. These two metallic oxides, which are amphoteric in matter, amphoteric in nature. What is the meaning of amphoteric means? They react with acid as well as base. As well as base. Because these metallic oxides are basic in nature, means when they react with acid, they form salt. Whereas aluminium oxide and zinc oxide, it is an exception of these two metals. They are amphoteric in nature. It means they can, when they react with acid, they will form salt. Okay. As well as when these metallic oxides react with base, they form salt in both the condition. So these are amphoteric in nature. Now children, we will just talk about the rest of the metals, silver, gold and platinum. These three metals, they do not react with oxygen in normal conditions, or even we can say they do not react with oxygen, because as we go down in the reactivity series, the reactivity of metal decreases, and this is the reason these are also known as noble metals. What are the name of these metals? These are known as noble metals. So this is all about reaction of metal with oxygen. The second chemical property of metal is reaction with water. When metals react with water, they form metal hydroxide or metal oxide with the evolution of hydrogen gas. On the basis of nature of product, means which product will be formed, we can divide all these metals which are present in reactivity series into three categories. First is highly reactive metals up to calcium. Second is moderately reactive metals up to lead. And metals which come below hydrogen in reactivity series, they are considered as least reactive metals. So children, when highly reactive metals react with water, they form hydroxide. So I am just writing here, high reactive metals when react with water, they form metal hydroxide. Okay, and what are the examples of these metals? Sodium, potassium and calcium. When these metals react with water, they form concerning metal hydroxide. Second category, it includes aluminium, zinc, iron and lead. When these metal reacts with water, they form metal oxide. So I hope it is more clear to you. Rest of the metals, copper, mercury, silver, gold, they do not react with water even at high temperature. So what we can write, that no reaction takes place when these metals are allowed to react with water. Now, here children, in this reactivity series, we skip one metal, that is magnesium, because it shows a different behavior. So we will discuss about the magnesium later on. Now, in this one, there is a reaction of water, and we know that water can be found in different state of matter. It may be cold water, it may be hot water, or it may be in steam, means it may be cold water, means the temperature is very low, liquid form, normal hot water. And if you talk about steam, that the water is found in gaseous form. Okay, so on the basis of these states of matter, means on the basis of temperature of water, again we divide these metals into three categories. First is metals which reacts with cold water, and this category includes potassium, sodium, calcium. Okay, this we have already written. So I can write here that these metals react with cold water. These metals react with cold water. Which are these metals? Potassium, sodium and calcium. Whereas aluminium, zinc, iron, lead. Okay, they react with only steam. It means they do not react with cold water. They do not react with hot water, they react only with steam. Okay, in this one there is no need to write the state of matter, because these metals, they do not show any reaction with water at high temperature also. Now we left magnesium. As I told to you that magnesium show a different behavior. It reacts with hot water as well as steam. Okay, when magnesium reacts with hot water, it forms metallic hydroxide, means magnesium hydroxide. But the reaction is not so vigorous. The reaction is not so vigorous. In this case, metal hydroxide is formed. when it reacts with steam, then in this condition magnesium, or we can say metal oxide, magnesium oxide is formed. Okay, it means the product which is formed in this reaction, it depends on the reactivity of metal, means how much metal is reactive, and second one is whether it is cold water, whether it is steam or it is hot water. One more point, children, potassium, sodium, calcium, they react with cold water. It doesn't mean that they do not react with steam, they do not react with hot water. They show reaction with hot water as well as steam, but the reaction is highly exothermic, and a large amount of heat is evolved during this reaction that we are not able to control this amount of energy in laboratory. So we generally avoid, or we have to avoid, these metals react with hot water as well as steam. Okay, second thing, aluminium, zinc, lead and iron, these metals, means this group of matter, it reacts with steam, means they do not react with cold water, they do not react with hot water. They do not react with cold water, they do not react with hot water. Okay, magnesium, it is a typical different behavior. So children, now let us start writing the reactions of all these metals with water. First is, when sodium reacts with water, the state of sodium is solid, the state of water is liquid state because it is cold water. So when it reacts, which compound is formed? That is sodium hydroxide, NaOH. Okay, with the what is the state of NaOH? Aqueous. With the evolution of hydrogen gas, it is in gaseous state, and heat energy also evolved in this one. Now, when is the chemical equation? That is 2Na plus 2H2O, it gives 2NaOH plus H2. The name of product is sodium hydroxide. Second reaction, calcium. When calcium reacts with water, the state of calcium is solid. It reacts with water, means it reacts with cold water, okay, then there is a formation of calcium hydroxide. The formula of calcium hydroxide is CaOH whole twice plus hydrogen gas. The state of water is liquid state, it is in solid state, it is aqueous solution. Now children, here I am not writing the symbol of heat energy, means the reaction of sodium and potassium is highly exothermic and highly vigorous also, but in case of calcium, the reaction is not so vigorous. The reaction is not so vigorous. Now next is aluminium. When aluminium reacts with, we just forgot to balance the reaction. That is CaOH whole twice 2H2O, done. Okay, now next is, when aluminium reacts with water, it gives aluminium oxide. I have written here the name of the product, that is aluminium oxide. The formula of aluminium oxide is Al2O3 plus hydrogen gas is evolved. Now we need to write the physical state of these reactants as well as product. Aluminium is in solid state. What would be the state of water here? Gaseous state, because we are talking about steam. These matters react with only with steam, only with steam. And hydrogen, that it is in solid state, and hydrogen is in the gaseous form. So this is the equation. Now we need to balance this equation. That is 4Al, 3 2s are 6, so we need to write here 6H2O, okay, and here 6Al plus 6H2O, it gives Al2O3 plus 6H2, it is balanced, 3 2s are 6, 6 here, 2 are 4. Okay, here need to write 4 AF. Now it is balanced. Okay. Then if we talk about iron, iron reacts with only with steam. So Fe plus S plus H2O, it gives Fe2O3 plus H2. Again we need to balance the reaction, that is 4. Here we will write 6H2O, 2Fe2O3 plus 6H2 in the gaseous state. Now, for writing the reaction of magnesium with water, as I already told to you that the nature of the product means which product is formed depends on the temperature of water. So when magnesium reacts with water and it is hot water, okay, then in this condition magnesium hydroxide is formed. So the formula of magnesium hydroxide is MgOH whole twice with the evolution of hydrogen gas. Second thing, when magnesium reacts with steam means H2O in the gaseous state, then magnesium oxide, okay, MgO is formed with hydrogen gas. So now we need to balance the reaction, that is 2H2O MgOH whole twice plus H2 plus H2, it's done. Now in this case MgO plus H2 already balanced. Okay children, so the nature of the product means which product will be formed, it depends on the reactivity of matter as well as the state of water, means whether water is cold water, it is hot water, or it is steam. Now next is calcium. It has some particular properties when it reacts with water. It shows some of the particular properties. When calcium reacts with water, it forms calcium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. The reaction is not so vigorous, that I already told to you. But after some time, you will see that calcium starts floating over the surface of water. How it happens? Children, in this one, hydrogen is evolved and hydrogen is insoluble in water also. Okay? So it comes over the surface of water. Hydrogen gas, it comes over the surface of water. Initially, calcium density is more than water. So when we drop a piece of calcium in water, it will settle down. But as soon as the reaction takes place, due to the formation of hydrogen, this hydrogen will stick to the surface of calcium. This hydrogen will stick to the surface of calcium, and that piece of calcium, it comes on the surface. It comes on the surface. Why it starts floating over the surface of the water? Because hydrogen gas which is formed during this reaction, it sticks to the surface of calcium, and because of this one, calcium starts flotation. In the same way, when magnesium reacts with hot water, magnesium also comes over the surface of water. So these are the two metals, which one? Calcium and magnesium. When they react with water, they starts floating over the surface of water. Children, in these reactions, you need to learn the reaction also, means you need to know how to write balanced chemical reaction. Second thing, proper product is formed, means which product is formed during which reaction. And third one, you need to learn all these exceptions also, means you should know that which matters react with cold water and what product is formed, and which metals react with hot water and what product is formed. And in board examination, the very simple questions that always be formed from these reaction is, one of the metal reacts with water and starts over the floating over the surface of water. So which metal starts floating? It may be calcium or it may be magnesium. Second thing, why calcium starts floating over the surface of water? The reason is only that when it reacts, hydrogen gas is formed. In all these reactions, hydrogen gas is formed. and this hydrogen stick to the surface of matter and it starts floating. Now children, there must be one question arise in your mind that ma'am, what's about potassium and sodium? They have to be start floating? Yes children, in my previous lecture in the physical properties of matters, I told to you that potassium, sodium and lithium, these are the three matters which have low density than water. So they already floated over the surface of water when we drop these matters into the water, because their density is lower than water. Okay, so there is no issue then when the reaction takes place, it comes to the surface. But in case of calcium, its density is more than water, yani iski jo density hai wo water se zyada hoti hai. But still density zyada hone ke baad bhi ye float kyun karti hai? The reason is very much clear to you, that hydrogen sticks to the surface of calcium. Children, this is all about the reaction of matters with water. If we talk about non-matters, they generally do not react with water. After completion of these chemical properties, we will discuss these question answers in our next video. Till then, bye.